the ratio between boys and girls in a class is 6:5. So can you say B is to G is equal to 6:5? Yes, the ratio between boys and girls is 6:5. Or B by G equals to 6:5. If 8 more boys join the class and 2 girls leave the class, then the ratio becomes 11:7. So ideally, how people solve this? Traditional method. Let me show you. I can say boys is equal to 6 parts, 6x, girls is equal to 5x. That's what they mean, 6 parts and 5 parts. Now what do we know? 8 more boys join the class. So how many boys? B dash by G dash, new ratio. B dash will be equal to 6x plus 8 divided by 2 girls leave the class. So actual girls 5x minus 2 because 2 girls have left. And this is equal to what ratio? 11:7. Now, can you simplify this to get the value of x? Yes, cross multiply. 7 into 6, 42. 42x plus 56 equals to 55x minus 22. So from this, you will get 13x equals to how much? 78, or x equals to 6. What's the question? What is the number of boys in the class now? What's the number of boys in the class now? What's the original number of boys? 6x. 6 into x, 6 into 6, 36. But the question says, what's the number of boys now? You know that originally there were 36 boys, 6 into 6, 36. But now how many have joined? 8 more have joined. So 36 plus 8, 44 is your answer. 36 plus 8, 44 is going to be the answer. Likewise, the question may say, how many girls are there in the class now? Originally, the number of girls was 5x. So 5 into 6, 30. 30 minus 2, because 2 girls have left. So 30 minus 2, 28 is the answer. Yes or no? So this is how you can solve these kind of questions. Some people joining, some people leaving, and then two respective ratios are given to us. Right? So just try to balance an equation and simplify that to get the required answer. But in my view, a waste of time, absolute waste of time. What's the smart way of getting the answer? This you would be able to understand if you have gone through ratio and proportions, ages and partnership. Simple logic here is, look at this. What is the original ratio? The original ratio of boys and girls is 6:5. So I know that boys are multiples of 6. Whatever is the number of boys, it should be a multiple of 6 because 6 parts and 5 parts. Are you able to follow? B is to G equals to 6:5 means what? Boys, 6 parts, girls, 5 parts. So clearly you know that the boys, number of boys should be multiple of 6. What about boys in the next case, new case, B dash is to G dash, 11:7. So I also know that now the boys should be in what ratio? I mean, boys should be a multiple of 11. That's it. That is one point which you need to follow. The number of boys now in the class should be a multiple of 11. Why? Because the ratio is 11:7. So obviously, boys will be some multiple of 11. 11x, 11 into something. Look at the options. First option, 28. Is it a multiple of 11? No, ruled out. First option cannot be the answer. Second option, 38. Is it a multiple of 11? No, this cannot be the answer. Third option, 44. Is 44 a multiple of 11? Yes. Satisfied, 44 is a multiple of 11. Yes, that means this may be the possible answer. How do you verify whether this is correct or not? Try to check this equation. We know that after 8 boys join, it becomes 44. That means what is the original number of boys? 44 minus 8, 36. And I also know that originally the boy should be a multiple of 6. Is 36 a multiple of 6? Yes, both the conditions are satisfied. I can say that third option is the answer. If at all you go for fourth option, 36. Is 36 a multiple of 11? No. So without having to write any of these steps on paper, just by the verification from the options, you can see that the correct answer is option 3. Right? Because now the number of boys is multiple of 11. And once you find that kind of an option, verify with the previous case. Minus 8 should be a multiple of 6. Both conditions are satisfied by third option.